In this next section, linear approximations and differentials, we are going to expand a little bit upon a concept that we've been working with throughout the semester, and that is equations of tangent lines and tangent lines themselves. But we're going to just get in graphically in this section, and we're going to talk a little bit more about how a tangent line can be used to approximate a function close to a specific point. And that process is called using a linear approximation to approximate the function, or to linearize the function, to come up with a linearization of the function, meaning approximating the function with a line. And of course, the line that we would want to use that would give us the best approximation to a function at a point is its tangent line. So what we're looking at right here is, of course, just a function and its tangent line at a specific point. We're looking at it at a, f of a, and what we've done right here is I've drawn in digitally the tangent line to this curve at a specific point. So if we were to zoom way in, and I know it gets pixelated when I do that, but if I were to zoom way in, very close to this point we have here, if we were to kind of just zoom in on maybe this little box right here, very close to that point, the actual tangent line is a very good approximation. Now there's a little error. You can see the little error right in here, of course, but the tangent line is a really good approximation to a point when we zoom in really close to that point. Now, of course, we wouldn't want to use the same tangent line to make an approximation out here. This is where that you can see the gap is growing as we move further and further away from A. So the tangent line itself, though, is a very good approximation to the function if we're close to the point that we've drawn in the tangent line to. So that's the idea of what we're going to do in this process, in this section. So let's go ahead and just talk about it. How do we come up with the equation of a tangent line? I'm not going to go through that again. That is something we have been doing often. To create the equation of a tangent line, to come up with the equation of a tangent line, we simply find the slope. Then we use the point-slope formula or slope-intercept formula to come up with the y-intercept. And if we're looking at a function at a point A, f of A, that's our ordered pair. The slope, of course, is just f prime of A. And we get this equation for the equation of the tangent line. So this is just the equation of the tangent line at x equals A, something we've done lots and lots and lots of times in this course. So if you want the equation of a tangent line, you find the derivative, you find the slope of the tangent line at a specific point by plugging that x value into the derivative, and then you write the equation of the line using some algebra. And we end up with an equation that looks like this, f prime of a times x minus a plus f of a. And that gives us this next definition, and we're going to do an example with it. So that gives us our next definition. The linear approximation, or the tangent line approximation, is a process of using the tangent line to a graph to approximate a value of a function near a specific point x equals a, or a f of a. So when we say a x equals a, that's giving us a point a f of a on the graph. And f of x can be approximated. So notice what we're saying right here is we're actually saying the function can be approximated by its tangent line, right? So the function is approximately equal to its tangent line. Notice that approximation. It's approximately equal to its tangent line when x is close to a, that picture that I showed you up above. When we zoom in, make a little box, the function itself behaves like its tangent line, or awfully close to its tangent line when we are close to a. And that is actually called the linearization of f at a. That's what we call when we use this tangent line to approximate a function. Okay, so let's do it. So let's sketch the graph of g of x equals the cube root of x plus 1 at a equals 0. So we've got a cube root function. I got a, b, and c here, so we'll work through these one by one. But a cube root function, and we are actually going to use Desmos to graph this too, but a cube root function has, you know, it has sort of this general shape like that. That's what the cube root function is going to look like. It has both, its domain is actually all reals because a cube root can have both positives and negatives. But that plus one shifts it back one. So we're going to go through right here, and at one, we have something that looks, running off the screen a little bit, but we're going to have something that looks like that. So that's the cube root of x plus 1. So there's x. There's our function. And we want to write the equation of the tangent line that represents the linear approximation to the function at x equals 2. Before we do that, though, let's go ahead and draw in that line. We'll just draw in that tangent line, and then we'll actually do the calculus to come up with the equation of that tangent line. So right there at x equals 0, we would have a tangent line that would look like that. So that's our tangent line at x equals 0. And if we wanted the equation of that tangent line, we would first have to find the derivative so that we could find the slope of the tangent line. So g of x, remember that g of x is equal to the cube root of x plus 1. So then g prime of x is going to be 1/3. You know, I'm actually thinking of this as x plus 1 to the 1/3. So g prime of x is just 1/3 x plus 1 to the negative 2/3 times the derivative of the inside chain rule, which is 1. And so g prime of x is just 1 over 3 times x plus 1 to the 2/3. And there's our derivative. We could think of that, I guess, as x plus 1 squared, the cube root of x plus 1 quantity squared, if you wanted to. I'm going to leave it with this rational exponents. So there's our derivative. The equation of the tangent line, first of all, the point that we would be looking at is 0 and g of 0. But if I plug 0 in here, I'm going to end up getting the point 0, and then it's the cube root of 1, which is just 1. We know that actually as well from the graph. We know that this point right here is at 0, 1. Just from our graphing skills. So there's our point, and then we can either use point slope formula, or we could use slope intercept formula and find b, whatever you want, but let's find the equation of the tangent line. So y minus 1 equals, oh, I haven't done g prime of 0. G prime of 0, the slope of the tangent line at that point, is going to just be 1/3, because when we plug in 0, 0 plus 1 is, so it's 3 times 1 to the 2/3, or 1/3. So the slope is 1/3, and then we have x minus 0, and so that becomes y equals 1/3 x plus 1. And that is the equation of the tangent line. I'm just going to circle it. That is the equation of the tangent line. If we were asked to give a linear approximation, what we could say here is that the linear, this is very specific. This is the equation of the tangent line at a point, at a specific point, at x equals 0. So we would want to say the linear approximation of g of x equals the cube root of x plus 1 at x equals 0 is, then you can write L of x is equal to 1/3 x plus 1. I'm getting to the bottom of my screen, just trying to keep it all on the screen there, but let's zoom in just a little bit so it's not so squiggly, it gets so small. 1/3 x plus 1. What I actually like to do, this was g of x, what I like to write is this. I like to just say g of x is approximately equal to its tangent line, 1/3 x plus 1 near x equals 0. That's how I like to write it, but you can write L of x equals 1/3 x plus 1, knowing that that's the linearization. I like writing it like this with the approximation because this is going to lend itself nicely to our very next step. The function itself is approximately equal to its tangent line. So that's what that's saying right there. The function is approximately equal to its tangent line near whatever point, near, and at this it was near x equals 0, but it's approximately equal to its tangent line near x equals a, whatever our a is. And so I like to write it that way because that gives me a good sense of what I'm talking about. Okay, so we've come up with the equation of the tangent line. I just want to show you of course, we can see that it's going to be a good approximation to the tangent line just from our little rudimentary graph, but I actually popped it into Desmos as well. So here is the actual curve in Desmos. So in the screen, let's zoom in a little bit. In the screen, you can see right now the actual curve, 1 + x⁓. And then I just went ahead and I already put in the tangent line we just found, which was 1/3 x + 1. And so what you can see right here is you can see how closely that tangent line does approximate that graph when we are near zero. I mean, we could zoom in. I mean, just you can almost, like, as you zoom in, you can almost not even see the difference between the tangent line and the curve. The curve behaves like its tangent line so much when we zoom in that visually we can't even differentiate between the two of them, between the red curve and the black curve. Okay. The red curve, of course, being the actual tangent line and the black curve being the function that we're looking at. So basically, if you think about drawing in a little box, I'm not going to be able to draw in a box in Desmos here, but if you draw in a little box around x equals 0 at the curve, at the point 0, 1, if you draw in a little box, you can see that within that box that linear function, that tangent line, is a great approximation for the actual function. And lines are a lot easier to work with than functions a lot of times. That's why we have this we have this whole topic where we talk about linearization, because lines are easy to draw, they're easy to graph, they're easy to talk about rates of change, right? Like, lines are easy mathematically to work with, whereas maybe the cube root function is not as easy to work with. And maybe a quick approximation using a line when we're doing some kind of application with a cube root is just as good as using the cube root function. So let's actually do an approximation. So now that we have this linearization, right, if we go through this process to come up with the linearization, find that equation of that tangent line, why not use it then to do some approximations? Because we know that the function itself is approximately equal to that. So what if we wanted to approximate these two values, the cube root of 1.1 and the cube root of 0.95. Now, I know we all have our calculators. They're sitting with us. Mine's right here. It's right next to me. And we could just pop that into a calculator and come up with, I don't know, 15 decimals worth of accuracy for the cube root of 1.1. But what if we wanted to do it with a linearization, or just to show that the linearization is pretty decent? Let's do it with the linearization. So we have just found the linearization of g of x, the cube root of 1 + x, to be x equals 0, to be 1/3 x + 1. That's what we've just shown, and I've got the graph right up there on the graph. So in Desmos. So if we wanted the cube root of 1.1, well, the cube root of 1.1 is simply the cube root of 0.1 + 1, just breaking apart so that it we can see how it would work into this function, which would be equal to g of 0.1. But g of 0.1, since 0.1 is near x equals 0, that's pretty close, a tenth is pretty close to 0, this has to be approximately equal to the linearization. Use the linear function. 1/3 times 0.1 plus 1. And what that comes out with when I actually do that and then I approximate it, I end up with it ends up being actually 1.03 repeating. So 1.03 repeating. If we went out a little further, that would be, of course, 1.03333 repeating. And I'm going to leave it like that, because if I go to the actual calculator, so now let's take, so that's what the linear, that was using a linear function. Now, if I actually used a calculator, remember I just mentioned we all have our calculator sitting right next to us, we could pop this into our calculator. If I went to the calculator returns out, I don't know, like 15 decimals of accuracy. I wrote down 6 or 7. So let's write down that. So 1.03228, and it keeps going. I'm going to stop there, because look at how close we got using that tangent line to the actual value, right? We got within, by simplifying this function down to a line, we were able to still get 2 decimals of accuracy here. And that's awfully good, out to the hundredth spot. So we're able to get 2 decimals of accuracy. If we were to get even closer to zero, because 0.1, we're a tenth We're a tenth away from zero. If we were to get even closer, so let's approximate that other number. We had the cube root, this will be even closer, the cube root of 0.95, which is the cube root of negative 0.05 plus 1. So now we're within 5 hundredths of zero. That would be g of negative 0.5. So let's do the same thing and see how accurate we get there. And if I plug that into the linearization, 1/3 negative 0.0, missing a zero there, negative 0.05, negative 0.05 times 1/3 plus 1, what I end up getting is, and again, I just went out, well, you know, this ends up being 0.983 repeating. So of course that would be 0.983333, on and on and on. And then when I went to the actual calculator and I did it, I just plugged in what's the cube root so my calculator could return out like 15 decimals of accuracy of the actual function versus the linearization. And we ended up, I end up seeing that the cube root of 0.95 ends up being 0.983 0, 4, on and on. And notice here that we are actually 3 decimals, just simply like plugging into that linearization, notice that we get within 3 decimals of accuracy of the actual value. So using that tangent line, right, we're zoomed way in on that graph when we're doing this approximation, and you're seeing that the error from using the linear function, the tangent line, and the actual function is very small. The distance between that red, visually, the distance between that red graph and that black graph as we get very close to zero is almost obsolete. It's like so small. Right? It's so small that depending on our application or what we're doing, we can often use the tangent line as an approximator. Okay, let me zoom out and get that all on the screen there. So there's that whole problem, using a tangent line to approximate an actual function. Okay. So again, nothing new here, just expanding off of what we have already learned. We know how to write tangent lines. We know how to take derivatives and find equations of tangent lines. It's now just saying, what can we use that tangent line for? What are some applications? What are some things that we can actually do? And one of them is we can use that tangent line to approximate values of the actual function, because the tangent line and the function behave like each other. The tangent line behaves like the function when we're very close to the point we drew the tangent line at.